We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Chef Jori Rieben is here from Aspire. We got seared salmon, spaetzle with sherry wine glaze.
Correct.
Okay, good. All right, nice to have you here. It's good to have you here this morning. Okay, tell everyone about the dish that you're going to make for us today.
Well, I'm going to make a pan-seared salmon today with over a bed of spaetzle. Spaetzle is like a egg noodle dumpling originated in Germany, Austria, and Switzerland. It's very unique.
Is it something that you can make from scratch, or
yeah,
is something that you can buy if you're not that, you know, you're a chef, you're very creative.
Yeah.
If you can't make it yourself, can you buy it at the store?
You probably could find it maybe at Whole Foods or so. It's not the same as if it's homemade. It's really nice. It's really nice when it's freshly made.
You know? All right, so we've got some ingredients here,
mm-hmm.
so that we can make this. First up, let's go over what we need to make the dish itself.
Well, spetzel, what I do is I take eggs, water,
uh-huh.
and milk,
right.
and I mix it with flour.
Right.
I mix it in a blender or something that mixes fast, so I to create a little bit of the gluten.
Uh-huh.
And then what we do is we actually have a pot of water boiling, and we put it through a spetzle sifter. You can buy those on Amazon or online somewhere maybe.
And that's how you make it with the boiling water.
Yep.
So it's basically a noodle that you make.
Yeah, noodle.
All right. So what else do we need for the salmon? You have the salmon here.
Salmon. I pan sear the salmon.
Mm-hmm.
I finish it in the oven at 375. It's a degrees. And on the sherry glaze, what we do is we take sherry wine, grenadine, and brown sugar, and we
right.
just reduce it all the way down to about 20%.
Okay.
And we also make an onion jam on top as almost like a garnish.
Nice.
It really goes well with the dish. We sear the onions together.
And you have two different types of onions here, right?
You have red and
red?
White.
Yep.
I go half-half.
Right.
This is a really simple way to make an onion jam.
Okay.
Red, white, some balsamic, and sugar. Just reduce it until it's a jam.
All right, good. All right, so we are ready to go. You can make this tonight. Maybe you can make it this coming weekend for a big 4th of July celebration. We are going to get to that. We're going to talk about Aspire coming up in just a little bit. Back to you. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Aspire is the restaurant. We have seared salmon on the menu, and that is what's crackling away right now.
Correct.
All right, tell us bring us up to speed. Let us know what we've done. And you're actually going to make?
I'm making spetzel right now. I have the sifter right over the boiling water.
Okay.
So I'm going to put the dough right on top.
Right.
And then with a little bit of force, I'm going to try to push it through.
And
anything
move it
that
through.
Works. Move it through, just like this.
And what is it? It just kind of drops down into the boiling water.
Yep, correct. Just like little dumplings.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll show you in a minute once I get this through.
It goes through. Actually, it's moved through pretty quick.
Yep.
And the consistency of that is a little lighter than dough. It doesn't seem to be as thick as a dough, right?
It is. It has to be able to be pushed through.
Okay.
And then
it just drops in there.
Drops in there, just like that.
That's perfect.
And then you wait until it boils up.
So after it's boiled up, then it's ready to go. Then you're done, right?
Then you cool it down quick, maybe in some ice water or cold water.
Right.
And then you can store it in your fridge, dried up for 5 days, no problem. You can make a big batch at a time.
And then after it's on there, then you took it and you placed it in this pan here.
Yep. And I heat it up in some butter, salt, and pepper.
And just let this sizzle away.
Just sizzle away. You can make it crispy. You can also do a dish by itself. You can
okay.
add cheese, bacon, anything.
And does it taste like a pasta?
Almost like a pasta, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, it goes well with almost anything.
Oh, good. Looks great. Okay, so now we have the salmon here, too.
Salmon, yep. Salmon I'm going to finish in the oven.
And how long did you have that on for?
The salmon I just seared on both sides. It's a quick, it's a golden brown. It's all how you want it, medium,
sure.
rare, medium.
And did you place anything else on it?
No, just salt and pepper, and that's it.
And that's it,
very
and then
simple.
Just let it simmer away. Okay, and then we've explained to everybody what we have here, too.
Well, here I started the onion jam.
Because that's what smells so good. It almost
yep.
smells sweet.
Yep, it is. Yeah, yep. I have sugar in there, I have balsamic in there, both colored onions.
Right.
So I seared the onions a little bit, very lightly, and then I added the balsamic and the sugar, and I'm just going to let it reduce all the way down to jam consistency.
It
very
smells great, and I'm sure you can put that on anything just as much as this here.
And
we're going to put everything together. That's all set to go. We'll show you what that looks like in just a little while. Put everything together, talk about Aspire and everything that's going on there. Back to you. Back in the Rhode Show kitchen, Monday morning is here. Chef Jori is here from Aspire. He has been making stuff all morning long. We got salmon cooked away, ready to go. All right, so tell us, tell everyone what you've done so far.
Well, I seared off the spetzel and a little bit of butter. You
mm-hmm.
can also use olive oil if you don't want any butter.
Right.
I'm gonna put it on the plate later. Salmon right on top. I pan sear the salmon, finish it in the oven. I have the onion jam going and the sherry wine glaze going right now.
I was talking earlier with some of the people around, you know, the set here. Salmon, I never really enjoyed it that much. Now I've realized not only is it extremely tasty, but it's very good for you, isn't it? It's a healthy food.
Yeah, it has it's good fats in it. It is, you know, healthier, has good protein.
Right.
Yep. It's really a good thing that people should be starting to introduce into their diets, isn't it?
Yeah, it would be good, yeah.
Perfect.
And this was very easy to make. You showed us how to make this before. You had that in the pan, mixed it together, and then you used the grate on top.
Yep, the grate.
And just kind of brought it through.
Just pushed it right through.
Dropped it in, and then you created this, took it, and then you were saying after it's in here, and after it kind of floats to the top, then take it and put it in.
Yeah, you want to ice it down or cool it down fast, and then strain off the water, and then you can add a little oil to it so it doesn't stick together, and you can even hold it in your fridge for a couple of days if you make a big batch at a time.
And then use this with anything. Put cheese on it, put it over any other dish that you want.
Pork. Meat, it goes well with almost anything.
I like the way you have this laid out. You're very organized.
Oh, thank you.
Sometimes we're in here, I don't know where anything is, but this is very well set up.
Appreciate it.
That alone
scores points. Okay, let's talk about Aspire. Let's talk about the restaurant. We need the address of the location.
Yep. Is 311 Westminster Street in downtown Providence. Yep, and we're open 7 days a week, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. We are also participating in the restaurant week coming up on the 6th of July to the 19th. We're doing lunch and dinner.
I was going to say, which is great for anybody who hasn't tried out Aspire before. Yep. Restaurant week goes over really big because you also prepare certain meals for just that week itself, right?
Correct. We have it's a 3-course dinner and a 3-course lunch.
Tremendous. And I know that Aspire, it's a great place. A lot of people I know have gone, you know, they're going out for an evening, maybe to Peatback or something. Mm-hmm. Yep. Stop in at Aspire first, very close by, very convenient, isn't it?
Yeah. Right before the show, we have a theater menu. Really nice, you know, eat some beautiful dinner and then go right to the show.
And then go right to the show.
See what I did there? I set up a lovely evening for the viewers out there. Yeah. You're welcome.
Date night is ready to go. All right, what do we got going on here? Because this is the onion jam.
Yep, it still has a little bit. It still has to reduce for probably another 10, 15 minutes.
And what does it look like when all said and done? Is it going to stay like this or it'll be
really sweet and dark in color? Just like this one right here.
Like that right there.
Yep.
Some people out there, when they think salmon, they may be a little intimidated by tackling this type of project by cooking it. They really shouldn't be.
No, it's very simple. I mean, it's just, you know, you can buy them already portion controlled.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just a quick sear, finish in the oven, even finish in the pan.
Right.
It's very simple.
This in the pan. All right, so let's plate this up so we can show everyone what this is going to look like. And what are some of the other things on the menu at Aspire? Not only just for restaurant week, but for any time of the year that people can go in and check out.
Yep, we have sirloin steak, we have filet,
mm-hmm.
we have a nice, it's a bone-in pork short rib,
mm-hmm.
Braised, and it's a ginger beer.
Okay.
What's really, really nice.
Ginger beer?
Ginger beer.
Oh, I like the sound.
That's nice.
I want to make sure I heard correctly.
So there's something for everybody if they head into Aspire itself.
Definitely. Many options.
Okay, put that on
so
there.
Good. Is there anything I can do other than just stand here and watch? Because I feel like... Oh, yes!
And maybe a little sherry
just
glaze
a little bit
over it?
Just like, a little bit here. This usually doesn't end well.
No, this over here?
Is that enough?
Nope.
No, not even close. I tried.
Just a little more.
He will not be my
friend. I tried.
And then just a little bit of onion jam right on top. This is beautiful for, like, you know, the summer.
Right.
Nice and light.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
And this can be used not just on fish, but anything.
Correct. All these components you can use on meat, pork, chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Goes really well. And then I have a little garnish from our rooftop garden that we started this year.
Which is also nice. A lot of people may not know that a lot of the herbs and everything are grown right there on the rooftop of the restaurant itself.
Correct.
So you're able to go upstairs and pick out what you want.
Yeah. Beautiful. Fresh.
Look what I did. See, I'm sorry about that. That's all right.
Still looks good. Still looks good. We'll show everybody what that looks like. And if you want the recipe to this or any information about Aspire itself, all you have to do is head to our website. It's WPRI.com.